I lived in the same house my whole life, and always had an eerie feeling when I was by myself, especially in the basement where my bedroom is. I used to frequently feel like I was being watched. When I looked out of the corner of my eyes, often catch something staring at me that would immediately disappear when I turned to look at it. As freaky as these experiences were, I never felt endangered by them. Then one night, I woke up around 3 or 4 in the morning and rolled over to the other side of my bed. When my head hit the pillow, I froze. There, in the top corner of my room, positioned like Spider-Man on the wall, was the thing I caught staring at me out of the corner of my eyes many times before. But this time, it was letting me get a good look at it. It was pitch black, blacker than black. Somehow devoid completely of light, but still containing enough depth for me to completely read its posture. And it had pure white, beady eyes that seemed to glow. It sat in the corner motionless, but fixed on me until I could break out of the fear-induced paralysis long enough to cover my head with my blanket. When I removed the blanket, it was gone. The thing is, I never felt like I was really in danger. Scared as hell, sure, but not in danger, as if the only thing it wanted was to observe me. The next morning, I told my mother what I'd seen. She's an interior designer who specializes in feng shui, and she performed some kind of cleansing ritual, used some rice and incense, and hung crystal in the corner of my room where I saw the shadow man. I am now 23 and haven't seen the thing since. About a year ago, I started dating someone who worked as a state park ranger, who I'll call Jay. Jay lived on the state park property in a 2-bedroom house tucked in the woods. We set the alarm and settled into bed around midnight, with Jay's 2 dogs between us, and a 3rd dog crated beside the bed. For some reason I couldn't fall asleep, so I lay listening to the dogs snoring in the deafening silence surrounding us while Jay slept. And then it started. A repetitive bouncing sound of some sort was coming from outside the window, less than a few feet from where I was laying on the bed. As if someone was dribbling a basketball in the cement. The pace was speed up and slowed down. The sound would become louder and softer. This continued for well over 2 hours. I wholeheartedly wanted to believe that what I was hearing were simply sounds of nature, so I ignored it. Next came the creaks in the walls. I know that houses make sounds, but this was unlike anything I heard before. These sounds started in the hallway as very, very faint creaks. The creaks became louder, and they reached Jay's bedroom. It would happen on the wall at a time, going counterclockwise around the room until it eventually reached the wall beside me. The creak in the wall beside me was so loud I jumped, and the 2 dogs jolted from their sleep. All the while, I'm still hearing a bouncing ball outside the window, again more nervous by the minute. And then, at 3 a.m., I hear it. I hear the most ungodly, terrifying growl shrieking from the center of the house. It was so loud that Jay flies off the bed, grabs a shotgun hanging on the wall adjacent to the bed, and shouts, "Is somebody in the house?" and takes off down the hallway towards the sound. The dogs are going berserk, and I'm in tears, absolutely beside myself, pleading with Jay that is not a person. Jay comes back into the bedroom after not finding an intruder or anything of the sort and says it must have been one of the dogs. I tell him it was certainly not the dogs. As I was awake the entire night, the dogs were asleep in the room with us. Maybe an animal got caught underneath the house. Maybe, I say. Somehow, after I calmed down a bit, I drifted off to sleep. The next thing I know, Jay is on top of me with his hands around my throat, with the meanest look on his face, jerking my head back and forth, suffocating me and hurting me. I can't make any sound, and I'm struggling to push Jay away, and that's when I wake up. It was all a vivid dream. Jay is asleep beside me. In the morning, we walk into the den to find the heater turned on full blast. It was the middle of summer. Jay only uses it during the winter months, as it is the original furnace and quite tricky to operate. I am convinced something in that house did not want me there. The growl will forever haunt me. Way back when my mother was only a baby and my uncle was 4 years old, my grandma invited some friends while their husbands went to drink at a pub. They had a nice house in the mountains, so it wasn't often that people ventured up there unless their intentions was to visit. After the men had left, the women decided to do an Ouija board. My grandmother had already put my mother to sleep, and so the only person in the house was my uncle, who was playing in the kitchen with him. They all put a finger on the planchette and asked generic questions. Is anyone here with us? Etc. etc. After a few minutes of trying, the planchette moved to yes. My grandmother was a little uncomfortable with this. But they carried on anyway. They decided to ask how the person died. The Ouija board spells out the sentence, "Cannot tell you." This confused them. My grandma asked why not, and if you tell them, there are too many years. My grandma tells me that this surprised them, and that they weren't sure how to carry on. That's when the planchette began to move again, and it tells them to send the boy out of the room, the boy being my uncle. My grandma is ashamed that she actually sent him into a different room. The planchette then starts to spell something else, but suddenly stops and instead spells out, "Someone is coming," and then hurriedly said goodbye. It turns out, my grandfather had forgotten his wallet and driven back to the house. My grandmother looks back on this and tells me she's glad they were interrupted. She never messed with a Ouija board since.